Hello everyone, welcome to video 6A, how different is Generation Y from Z? We have two objectives for today. The first one, use how questions to get more information, and two, discuss about how the generations differ from each other. We are talking about specifically about two generations, Generation Y and Generation Z. In the video, we are going to see some differences. Don't forget to check them, please, and take notes. If you have any questions, ask your teacher.
How do these generations compare? That's what we'll be looking at today, in this episode of the Infographic Show, Millennials versus Generation Z. Though these two groups sit side by side on the generation ladder, the expansion of the internet and the leaps that have been made with the digital revolution has seen them exposed to a host of different experiences. Add to that the influence of parents from different generations, and we have plenty of scope for differences in attitude and behavior. We've reviewed what researchers have said, so we can bring you our list of 10 ways these generations compare and differ. Let's take a look. Number 1. Attention span. Generation Z processes information faster than any other generation, including millennials. They live in a high-tech world of constant updates, and having grown up with access to apps such as Vine and Snapchat, their attention span is likely to be lower than that of millennials. A study showed that while only 4% of millennials and older generations believe 13 is an okay age for owning a smartphone, as high as 18% of Generation Z members think it is an okay age. Number 2. Multitasking. A short attention span is not always a drawback, and what Generation Z lack in focus, they make up for in their multitasking capabilities. Generation Z can work on a school assignment on their computer and do research on their tablet, all while taking notes. And in the evening, they will often sit in front of the TV watching a movie, at the same time chatting with a friend on Facebook from their phone or laptop. It's head-spinning stuff. Number 3. Independent versus collaborative. 71% of Generation Z say they live by the phrase, "If you want it done right, then do it yourself." Generation Z tend to be more competitive and will adopt a do-it-yourself mindset in personal or professional activities. And when it comes to workspaces, 69% of Generation Z would rather have their own workspace than share it with others, whereas millennials would opt for a collaborative working environment where they can team up with their colleagues. Number 4. The digital pioneers. 40% of Generation Z say that reliable Wi-Fi is more important than reliable bathrooms. And according to Pew Research, only 14% of US adults had access to the internet in 1995, but by 2014, 87% had access. Millennials saw firsthand how social media revolutionized the way in which we communicate. They were pioneers in the digital age, witnessing the birth of smartphones, instant messaging, and internet searching capability. Generation Z were born into this tech-immersed society, and so have a very different perspective. Number 5. Face-to-face or digital chat. All this technology has also had an effect on how these generations differ with communication habits, and 74% of Generation Z say they prefer to communicate face-to-face with colleagues in the workplace. As we just mentioned, millennials pioneered many of the digital communication tools, which revolutionized how we do business. But with Generation Z preferring a more personal approach, maybe they are the ideal generation to strike the right balance between online and offline workplace communications. Number 6. Optimistic vision. A 2016 survey conducted by Lincoln Financial Group tells us that Generation Z are far more optimistic than the millennials. 50% of Generation Z say America is heading in the right direction versus 42% of millennials. 64% of Gen Z have started researching or talking to others about their financial futures by age 13. And after they've started having those conversations, 95% of those making financial plans feel optimistic about their future in general.
Well, let's ask how questions. We use how questions. Well, how is an adverb that has many possibilities. First, it can modify some words, right? We are learning today the different meanings when it modifies an adjective or an adverb. So how plus an adjective? It indicates a degree, a quantity, or some dimensions, right? Let's see some examples. All. So when we use how plus all, it means that we are talking about the age. For example, how old is your mom? Heavy. When we use how plus heavy, we are talking about the weight. The example is, how heavy is your laptop? And responsible, that is another adjective. We are talking about the degree of responsibility of a person. For example, how responsible are the teenagers? So, how plus an adverb, it indicates how you do something. How well do you eat? Hi, do you eat fruit and vegetables? Frequently, right? That is another adverb, and talked about the frequency. How frequently do you use social networks, right? We are talking about the different generations. So let's practice. In the practice, we are making a suitable how question for these answers, right? Let's see the example. We have, I never eat vegetables or fruit and I love fast food. Well, the correct question or a suitable question would be, how healthy do you eat, right? So now it's your turn. We got this answer. I get good grade at school and do my homework. What would be a good question for this answer? How good do you do it at school, right? Or how good are your grades? There are different possibilities here. My brother cooks all kinds of food very well. How well does your brother cook? That is another possibility. So, don't forget to do homework. Please make sure to complete the video and do the video checking questionnaire below. See you next video. Here are the references. Bye.
Universidad Santo Tomás, institución vigilada por el Ministerio de Educación Nacional.